SNP's Rural Affairs spokeswoman Deirdre Brock was shut down after demanding the British government cover the potential costs of new duties the EU may impose amid the ongoing Brexit protocol debacle. The British government and the European Union have been at loggerheads over the implementation of the Northern Ireland Protocol included within the Brexit agreement struck last year. Brussels has refused to renegotiate the protocol and has warned the bloc may seek to introduce new levies aimed at UK exports into the EU. SNP MP Deirdre Brock challenged the government to commit to paying any extra cost farmers may face should tariffs be imposed. But she was quickly shut down as Victoria Prentice noted the sector will benefit from Brexit in the long term. Ms. Prentice said, "I don't think it's any secret to this house that I was no Brexiteer. But I must say that for farming and fishing, we have really gained from Brexit. In England, we don't think the environment can wait. We want to start paying public money for public goods to our farmers. And that's how they will be supported in the future. The government has long insisted Britain's departure from the EU will open up new trading opportunities for both farmers and fishermen in the UK. A historic trade deal struck last month with Australia was hailed as full of potential due to the new market set to become available to the British agricultural sector." Ms. Brock, however, had suggested failure to comply with the protocol aspect of the Brexit deal may impact the UK's chances of striking new trading arrangements and erode the trust potential partners have in Brexit Britain. The SNP MP said, "The UK government indicated it was willing to break its own trade deal with the EU because of the consequences they told us wouldn't happen. The EU may very well implement tariffs on UK exports to the EU, as they have a right to do under the Tory negotiated deal, which would be calamitous for our agricultural sector." Just days ago, the New Zealand Prime Minister warned failing to keep to treaty commitments could threaten membership of the CTPPT. Will the Secretary of State or Minister commit to covering extra costs to farmers this whole sorry mess is causing? Or are the consequences of this ideological Brexit crusade to be borne by everyone but the UK government and its ministers?